Okay, good afternoon, Mark. Awesome to have you here as always. I've set this one up as well in memory and in honor of our good friend Alan Davison, who passed yesterday, but very sad news. But on a better note, and on a note that I think Alan would appreciate, is we wanted to talk all things good and doing good in the world through product launches. But firstly, I'll let you say a few words. I know that knew Alan as well, and we might have a little bit of a chat about that first, and then we can go from there.
You know, these are always very upsetting times when you receive unexpected news like this. Alan was such a genuinely sincere and empathetic person, really just genuinely great. And I'm just still in shock. I mean, it's only been a few hours that I've heard the news, and it just seems like he was in great spirits the last time that I chatted with him. He was doing great and everything was good. And we just never know how long we're here. And every day could be the last day. So it just reminds me to live in gratitude and live in a spirit of thankfulness for the connections that we do have and be appreciative for the time we have together, because it could be at any point that we're done.
It's definitely sad news. I'd spent a fair bit of time with Alan and his partner Jim in Austin, Texas, and in Durango, and at different business events and that sort of thing. And I'm sure you did too, Mark, that just a absolutely lovely guy, just a huge heart, always smiling, always happy. And he was one of those guys that you rarely meet. He was someone you remember, and it's, I'd.
And you know, when these kinds of things happen, Alan was definitely the kind of person who made a difference in the world. And for
Oh.
that, I'm thankful. And for that, I'm grateful for having had the opportunity to know him and have shared some good times with him. And it's a good conversation and some thought-provoking and really sincere, empathetic times. He's just really a great guy and will be missed a lot.
I'm sorely missed. And yeah, you're right. Alan was one of those guys. He did amazing things in the world, and we all went through kind of product launch manager together many years ago, and Alan was one of those guys out there doing it. I know that he's had a huge impact in the tapping community. Was doing huge things there for years and years and years, and still working in that community, and just impacting a lot of lives. And as our mentor kind of says, Jeff Walker, you're out there doing product launches to create a ripple effect in the communities that you serve. And none of us really built big audiences, but we're serving huge audiences through our clients. And Alan was, I mean, I could not even, he would have touched millions of people with what he was doing. And that was, it's testament to who he was. Just a fantastic guy.
I think one of the things that made Alan so remarkably successful was his openness and his awareness and his degree of empathy. He can relate to anybody in any given situation. And as a result of that, he was able to communicate and connect on a very deep level.
I mean, he entered the tapping market, I know, fairly soon after we completed product launch manager training, and from the get-go had huge success in that market. And it was just, it's fantastic to watch. He was perfectly suited. He was just a big cuddly bear. We all know that. Just a great, fun-loving guy. But like you say, hugely empathetic, and that which made him a great marketer as well. product launches were his thing too. And I know he helped his clients produce great results. And that's, you know, when something like this, you know, when someone passes, you always have to think about, you know, I kind of always think, well, why are we here? You know, what are we doing here? Are we doing good work? You know, are we doing good things for good people? And, you know, Alan was kind of right at the top of the tree there, doing good things for good people. Hats off to him. I'm sure, well, I hope he's smiling somewhere up there now. You know, he's just one of the smiliest guys I know. So, I hope that everything's good for him or better for him, wherever he is. Tough topic, I have to say. Tough topic, but we'll move it towards product launches in honor of Alan. And maybe we can kick it off and just run through, maybe if you can give us your thoughts on some of the real benefits of product launches, Mark, the way you see them. They've become hugely popular. I mean, Jeff Walker kind of changed the landscape with product launches, and essentially everyone has done one just about, or, you know, they're still popular. They're still being rolled out. They're still famously successful. They are, you know, just a brilliant way of rolling a business out. Give us a little bit of your insight. I know you've done your fair share, so a little bit of insight into how you see launches and how you see it can benefit others.
Well, I think anybody that's got a product or a service that they want to really market, a product launch formula is a fantastic way of doing it. I've been a big fan of Jeff since the first time I saw him speak at a group called the System Seminar back in 2003.
Right.
This was before product launch formula.
Yeah, that's a long time.
And he was really the ultra introverted kind of geeky guy. And I was always intrigued by, you know, what he was doing. And then in 2005, he came out with the very first version of product launch formula, which was on CDs and in a, you know, a binder. And I still got it someplace, the old school way of doing things.
Yeah.
And so I've been a supporter of product launch formula from day one. But it really wasn't until 2009, when we hit the financial crisis, that I decided to try and do this. And like so many people, I said, well, you know, this is going to really work. I don't know if it's going to work. And this was, you know, back in the day, back in 2009, video was hard.
Yeah.
And you had to do it on a camcorder. You couldn't do it on a phone. And yeah, it was hard to edit. And I didn't know anything about putting websites up. And I didn't know any of that stuff. But somehow I said, you know, I've got a big following, pretty big following in my area. Nobody had ever done anything like a product launch, and they really weren't marketing with email marketing or anything like that. But I had a list of about 6,500. And so I decided to do a launch. And I put this thing together over a 3-week period, and I launched it. And I'll never forget my wife. You know, she was like, oh, you're going to do that internet thing. And I said, yeah. And she goes, okay, when are you going to do it? I said, well, the cart goes live tomorrow at 8:00 in the morning. She goes, okay, I'll get some Starbucks coffee and I'll come by. And she was going to, you know, take some pictures of me doing this internet thing, right? And she goes, how much are you going to sell your product for? And I said, $597. She goes, wow, that's a lot of money. Somebody's going to buy something on the internet for $5.97. And I said, yeah, I think so. I hope so. And I'd had tremendous interaction. I'd put some training videos up that were really good training videos. They'd gotten
perfect product launch formula style.
Exactly. And they've gotten 5,000 views that week. And I was just stunned that 5,000 people could find these videos. And I'd done some, you know, some mailing to the list, letting them know when the email, the things were going up. And this was before YouTube. So you couldn't put them on YouTube. You had to put them on, like, you know, up in the cloud. You had to do it on AWS or something like that. I don't even remember what I did, but it was hard. Anyway, so I got this thing working, and there were so many people waiting for the cart to turn on that I couldn't get in to turn the cart on. They were pitting the server. And she goes, so my wife's going, what's the matter? Are there not, doesn't it work? And I said, I don't understand this. I don't know why it's working. And then finally, after about 20 seconds or so, I got it turned on and immediately started going, bing, 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 bing. And my wife goes, what was that? I said, that's $597 every time that pings. And the look on her face was just priceless. It was like, holy criminy. And in the first 15 minutes, we did $12,000 worth of sales. And I said, you know what? This is serious.
That is exactly product launch formula. And I've got a similar story. going back, like, I first heard about Jeff Walker and product launch formula in about 2006, I think 2007. Now, I'd been way down the rabbit hole since 2003, 2002, as far as online kind of stuff. And around that time, I had another company in the kind of physical, in the construction industry. And I was just learning with all the free stuff that Jeff was giving away. Mm-hmm. You know, I'd find the occasional email or a video or something, you know, like some instructional online. And I was learning kind of out of all the free stuff. And I was using that to grow this construction-based company. And that grew really quickly. Everything was going fantastically. And then Product Launch Manager was offered. And I remember, like, I was so green to the whole, I was still very green to the whole internet marketing thing. And his videos, I've still got them saved. I can send them across to you. They're actually quite funny. I was completely sucked in. And I, like, he, you know, there was an application, and now applications are commonplace. And, you know, we're sick of, you know, filling applications in to get on a call or do.
Oh, yeah. Anyway. Oh, yeah.
But back then it was like a big deal. And I remember filling in this application as if my life depended on it. Like I was going for the job of my life. And
you got to frame it also in terms of the price of doing it. Not inexpensive.
No, it was a $25,000 offer with $5,000 up front. Like, just to fill in the application, you had to put your $5,000 in up front. And this is US. This is back in 2009. So it was a bit of money, you know, and it was certainly a lot of money for those times on the internet. And, you know, obviously went to LA, did the training, came back, everything. But I do remember my second launch, because the first launch went pear-shaped because of the client, and the client hired me back with another fee. But I remember sitting up at 2 a.m. and Skype calling my client and going, okay, cart's gone live. Everything should be good. What's going on at your end? And all I could hear was ding, 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 ding. And I was like, what the hell is that? Turn that off. And he said, I've got an alarm set. Every time we make a sale, it dings. And it was dinging for hours on end.
Yeah.
Hours on end. It went on to make $103,000 in that 5 days. It was phenomenal. And that just explains product launch formula to a T.
So what was happening during that time? I was in a manufacturing operation. We were losing money hand over fist. I was spending $20,000 to $40,000 a month just to keep it going. And that was on top of $1 million that I'd put in to a brand new building right before the economy collapsed. So I was bleeding cash like fast, and I needed some way to infuse. And so I generated 20 some odd thousand on the very first seed launch off my list of 6,500 people. And I had a friend of mine whose company had just filed for bankruptcy, but he had a list of 100,000 people on his list that matched my market. Ooh. And so I literally edited a video, jumped on a plane and flew down to Phoenix and said, let's shoot a video in your yard. I'll do a joint venture split. We'll mail to your list. We'll do this video together and we'll see what we can do. And he was in foreclosure on his house. The bank was going to take it. Ooh. And he was freaking out.
Yep.
And he goes, I got nothing to lose. I've already lost the business. I've got everybody's after me. So we went down there and filmed the video, and it was, of course, 150,000 degrees. You know, you might as well have filmed it in an oven. It was so hot. But we filmed it, and I flew home and edited that night and then put it up for a seven-day rollout to his list and my list that hadn't bought yet. And a week later, we opened the cart, and it was open for a week, and then I closed it down, and it was 103,000, just about the same as yours. And I can't tell you how great it felt to send him a cashier's check for $25,000 that saved his house.
Oh, beautiful.
Was awesome. It was awesome.
I think this, and we all kind of got into this right in the middle of the financial crisis, and it was mind-boggling. Like I remember people asking me, like, James, what are you doing? Like, kind of just like dumbfounded, because I was excited and I was just sharing my results on Facebook. I was still naive and green and just posting these results going, this is amazing. And people were just blown away. In the middle of the financial crisis, people were saying, what the hell are you doing? And that is the power of product launch formula. And it's, we haven't really gone into the details of product launch formula. A lot of people know about it, but back in those days,
how's that?
People should actually jump on Jeff's website or Amazon or something and buy that today, because it's a great book. But
we're both in the book, by the way.
Yeah, actually we are. But what I wanted to say was, back in those days, in 2009, I remember doing like the launch that we did for to raise that $103,000 in 5 days was literally done on a blog. So we posted 3 videos just on a guy's blog site that he'd been blogging for a while. There was no funnels. There was no sexy sales pages. The cart was ugly. The pages were ugly, but the information was timely and relevant. And I think that's the important thing, that people have to get past all these funnels and softwares and all this sort of stuff, and make sure that the message is timely and relevant. And that's, probably the biggest thing I learned out of marketing in, overall, it's like there are some basic principles to marketing that if you get right, it will work. And no graphics,
right?
No video, fancy stuff, no music in the background, no fancy microphones, no nothing will fix that. If that messaging is off, or that, if you don't have those few principles of marketing right, it just won't work. And like Jeff said to us, keep it simple, stupid.
Right.
I remember him saying that to us, like, just keep it simple, stupid. And it really stuck for me. And like, I continued on doing launches in a very basic manner all the way through. I still do it the same basic way. Rarely go to any expensive, building fancy funnels and all this, stuff. And they still work because the foundations are there.
Well, and I think one of the reasons why we had such spectacular success early on, and what I was selling was absolutely to a micro niche. It wasn't to a big market like health and fitness or Forex or something yep. like that. This was a very esoteric, elite 4% of the entire market was interested in this subject. And maybe out of those 4%, maybe 10% were actually doing it. So this was a micro model that worked. And I even had some clients in Australia that bought, that still I'm in contact with to this day, 10, 11 years later. But in those days, because it was so primitive, we really focused on the fundamentals. And I think that's where people lose it today, is they get, there's so many shiny objects, there's so many things that are going to make it easier, but you need to have it hard the first time so that you focus on the fundamentals and you really do concentrate on the things that are important.
Yeah, it's like I'm just onboarding a new client at the moment, and I have a big questionnaire that I send them and they fill it in, and she goes, oh, I notice you've read Cialdini. And many marketers today wouldn't know who he is, and they wouldn't have read him, they wouldn't have studied him, they probably haven't read his book 5 or 6 times like I have. It is those fundamentals that turns all the levers. And you can make, I remember some of the websites we had back in the day were so ugly.
They were horrible.
But
ugly websites convert.
Yeah, well.
It's like people get distracted by the pretty,
And to be honest, they still do. They still work very well. I'd actually know a couple of high-end marketers that still use some of the old graphics looking very
1997 look.
Very much so. Very early
underlined blue links and
very early 2000s. But it's great to see. And just back to launches. One of the other big things, of course they make you a lot of money, or they make you a little bit or a lot depending on your level of whatever you want to. It's all relative, but they do, like you mentioned there, that you've got clients out here that you still talk to 11 years later. They do create raving fans for your business.
Yes.
And they kind of, it's like you're bringing people into the fold and entrusting them with, some sort of secrets that you have. And we all know there's no secrets anymore, but there's a huge level of trust built by Product Launch Formula. And
by design. By design.
By design, but done well, it really goes to another level. And there's this, there's a lot of talk of authenticity. And in Product Launch Formula, just going through the motions and doing it like real, not try, like if you were really trying to teach something and not trying to just sell something, there's a huge level of trust and authenticity that's passed on, which creates that raving fan that, they can't get enough of you, and they kind of become very close friends, and that's what all of my clients, I've wanted them as close friends kind of thing. You want to be able to hang out with them. It shouldn't be like you're just trying to sell something. And I think Product Launch Formula breaks that barrier there when it's done correctly.
I go back and I re-examine the launches that I've done, and I've done a bunch of them, probably not as many as you have, but I've done enough. There's certain things that are recurring, and one of them is that when you launch and you relaunch and you relaunch and you relaunch, the life just keeps on going. It does. It's not like it's the end of life, which is really great.
Yeah.
But the other thing, the bigger thing, when it comes to this concept of authenticity and being genuine, what I've noticed is that during the run-up, the pre-launch, when you're really educating the audience to what you're doing, it's like when you were a kid and they had those books, those dot-to-dot books where, that have the pages and then you got to color, connect those dots. Well, the pre-launch is like putting the dots on the page and you can kind of make out what's going on, but the actual delivery of the product itself is where you connect the dots and you do it quickly. And so you're giving the audience and the market the big picture of what you're doing in order, exactly as it needs to be done. No surprises. But then when you open the door, it's like, okay, now let's connect the dots and let's do it quickly and get a great result.
Yeah. And that's, it's, I, like I see a lot of marketing online today, and it's a little bit deceptive where they're making huge promises at the start. They're not really showing you how to, how it's done, and then presenting a magic trick if you only if you give them some money, and then the delivery is often poor at best. And it's sad to see. Whereas on the flip side, if you product launch formula way is deliver everything up front, tell them exactly what's going on, tell them how it's done, tell them like essentially 99% of it. And then on the back end, you're delivering way more value by actually helping people do it. And it's, you know, it's product launch formula is still the most pivotal product I've ever purchased. And I haven't purchased a lot, I have to say, because I'm not a big course consumer or anything like that. I prefer to just kind of invest a lot of money and get, you know, straight from the horse's mouth. But that's, product launch formula has still been the most impactful, the most profitable, the most rewarding, the most enjoyable, the most, you know, authentic. And I like 11, 12 years later now, I still feel a close bond with Jeff, and I would still bend over backwards to help him in any way I could, you know, and that tells a story about the process and what it can do for you and your company and your product and your clients.
You know, another real important thing here, and this is part of the secret sauce of product launch formula, is that
I have to pull you up there because that's Jeff's words, the secret sauce.
What?
That's great to hear. But, you say
it's subliminal. But really what makes it work is conceptualizing the educational portion of the pre-launch. Because when you do it properly, if you're truly an expert in your area, which I really would hope that you would be if you're going to be launching products and training people, you're meeting the market where they are on their journey, which is far, far, far back from where you are right now. The big danger people have is telling them too much too soon, which is what creates confusion.
Yeah.
So when you create those, the environment, you define the problem and you create the solution around the problem. And then when you open the doors, then it's all okay. You've got the foundation. We've given you the foundation. Now let's really put the special stuff in on it here and really get it going good. And that just really resonates with people.
I think that, and that was the real power of using product launch formula in its full kind of, I guess, the full formula, moving from seed launch to internal launch to JV launch, back to internal launch. Doing that allows you to bring people on the journey from, you know, the very beginning of where they are and where you are, mm-hmm. into like the internal launch where you take them a step further, going to a JV launch and getting to a wider audience, and then, you know, back to an internal launch. I always used to, and I still do, like if a client comes on board and says, I want to launch something, I'm always saying we're three launches away from where we want to be. Okay, where firstly, and they might be starting at a seed launch. Rarely do people come to me starting at a seed launch. It's more so an internal launch or a JV launch. But I'm always saying we're three launches away from your real payday kind of thing. And if you just want some money up front now, you're going about this in the wrong way. Because you can 10x your results or even 20 or 100x your results by planning this out as a strategy to roll out three or four launches. I've done it many times with clients where I've taken three launches, like beginners, from three launches to like $1 million business. And that continues to grow and continues to thrive using the full formula, not just one piece of it, not just trying to rush to get a payday, rush to build some authority or whatever it might be. The power of using the whole formula is incredible, incredible. And same with just the single pieces, but the whole thing together, it's like to launch a business, to launch a product. I always think, if new clients come to me, I'm always thinking, okay, where are we 3 launches from now? What's the end result that I really see if we pull this off? And, for people out there doing launches and stuff, like take the slow road, take the long, slow road, because it will pay, and there's nothing wrong with money, but if you're chasing it up front, you're often doing yourself a disservice. Go for the slower, longer path.
Yeah, I think one of the classic telltale signs, not really even telltale, but a classic sign that you're in it for the wrong reasons is a high refund rate.
Oh, yeah.
We see these people that are jumping in, doing these product launches, making the outrageous claims, pulling the rabbit out of the hack, but don't really say how it's going to work. That's where the high refunds come in. And if you're really being authentic and you're really being genuine and you're really being helpful in driving a business, there is no refund rate. I mean, my refunds literally have been zero. I think total in the entire time I've been online, I've given maybe 3 refunds. And 2 of those refunds, I voluntarily said, here's your money back. I can tell you're not happy. I can tell that you're embarrassed to talk to me about this. Your fault, my fault, nobody's fault. Here's your money back. But I have never, ever had anyone file a claim or file a refund or be angry. Usually it's like, I didn't realize I was this thin in my bank account and, there's any way I can get my money back. It's that kind of a thing.
Yeah. And like this thing, product launch formula and marketing in general is very powerful. Like good marketing is very powerful, and it has to be used for good. It has to be used for good. And there's always going to be the people that are using it for bad and for evil, and for we've only got to talk about the government now using marketing for evil. But we won't go down that path today.
Thank you.
But using marketing for good, it is massively powerful. And, product launch formula falls right in alignment with it. I've still got I could run out and get it, but I've still got a little pocketbook. It was only a small pocketbook. And I literally, when I was going through product launch formula the first time, I took copious amounts of notes, and I had a big book and I had this little notebook. And in this little notebook, I had all of the sequences, the mental triggers, the events and the staging and all that sort of thing, all tagged in this little book, so that at any time I was in a launch, I could go to an exact page and I knew exactly, okay, right, on this day, that's the mental trigger that I should be hitting. This is the sequence, how it should be happening, in all of that kind of detail. And, I often think about that and like pull that book open occasionally just to go, I was right down the rabbit hole and loving it. As I said, I was very naive, I guess, at that time, but doing it with a pure desire to do good in the world. And, speaking of that, I'll bring up Alan again. He was one of these guys that was out there doing such good work in the world and just from a really genuine place. He will be sorely missed in that community, I'm sure. Going back to product launches, I know there's been huge kind of progression in product launches and in marketing online in the last 10, 11, 12 years now. Is there anything that you see as being super impactful as far as, something that's should be included in a launch, or like for me personally, I'm still of the view that if you were to buy Product Launch Formula today and actually study it, like really, really put some time into it. Like I took a full month from probably 6 a.m. till 8 p.m. and consumed every single part of it, made copious notes. Like I knew that thing inside out before I flew to LA.
That's great.
Is there anything that you see just in new marketing in the last 10, 11 years that should be added to Product Launch Formula or?
Yeah. So one of the things that always kind of chafed me a little bit about Product Launch Formula was the bubble. You know, there's this big push to go through. You have a super high sales and then the sales drop off. And you go into a 6-month delivery cycle and deliver the work over 6 months or 3 months or whatever. And then you repeat the cycle again. So you basically get 2 launches a year out of any given market. What I've always felt, and one of the things that I've done with my coaching program is to basically do the launch once a year, but to create an engagement model for the people that don't get in. So there's a certain number of people, the timing may not be right. The money may not be right. You know, their circumstances may not be right. And to only have them able to come in once a year or twice a year, it can kind of mess up your continuity. And it really depends a lot on your business model, because I know Jeff's business model is about having a lot of time off. And, you know, he wanted to have, you know, a couple of months at a time where he could go down the raft down the river or, you know, get away and do whatever he wanted to do. And that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that at all. But I just know that from basic physics, the inertia that you have to overcome from a cold start takes so much more effort than just try and maintain a slow forward moving progression. And for me, it's always important not to resell the same content. So essentially what I tell my folks are, look, when you get into the launch, when you get into the program right now, you're getting an acceleration of the content that will eventually be released to the public. It has a shelf life. So this is your head start. And that really gives them an opportunity to be in front of the market sooner rather than later and to have a longer life with that technology. But they know that this is not the end all be all, that things are going to continue to evolve. And I think this is one of the reasons why clients have stuck with me continuously over the years is they know that they're getting in at the earliest time for the least amount of money they ever will. And the results of all of my programs are based on the results of the program. So if the price goes up, it's because the results went up, and you can't argue with that. You know, it's like, I'm not raising my price if the results aren't going up. And if they're not going up, then I'm changing things up because things have to be going up.
Yeah. So in that, are you saying like some sort of evergreen model should be part of it,
right?
or just maybe an ongoing launch scenario where you're just able to drop people in at any time?
There's a lot of different ways you can do it. You can drop people in on given dates. Like I can only take 300 today, but I can add another 330 days and I can add another 130 days and another 160 days. So you can do it that way, or you can do it in such a way. There's, you know, it could be an evergreen model with the same content, or it can be evolutionary beyond that.
Sure.
At a higher rate. So it's like, if you don't get in right now, you can get in later, but it's going to be $100 more, something like that. So there's lots of different variations on this. And really, it really comes down to crafting the model that you like to work with and that's fair and gets the results for your clients. The more that you do this, the more that you work in a market, and I don't mean you, and I'm talking collectively, the more that anyone works in a market, the more expert they become, the more insight you gain. So your experience and your expertise grows enormously, exponentially, when you collaborate with 300 people at the same time. You get insights that they would never get because they're gaining insights from where they are, but you're gaining insights from the collective whole. And that is, there's no way to put a dollar value on that.
Yeah. What are your thoughts on the way a lot of marketing is done these days, like say a normal book launch where it's a book, there's a video, there's a guy selling a book, you know, it's free shipping. You know, there's an upsell straight to maybe the audio version or a small course, and then that drives into a larger funnel. How do you rate that in comparison to like a true product launch formula style launch where it's...
Well, that model is what's called a self-liquidating offer model, a slow model. And the idea being is that you sell the book for the cost of the book and the shipping, and that pays for your advertising. And, you know, at that point, then you can promote the heck out of the book, which adds the value of the book in the marketplace, and you can show the demand for it is there, which validates your expertise. And then you build into the course from there. It's one way of doing it. It seems overly complicated to me at this point. And it's dependent on Google and Facebook's advertising model in the space that you're working with, whether that'll work or not. If you're in a highly competitive space like weight loss or fitness or supplements or something like that, ooh, that's going to be a hard nut to crack because that's real expensive competition.
If you're in
some really rare space like growing chanterelle mushrooms, you know, there's not very many people that can grow chanterelle mushrooms nor would want to, but that's the kind of space where a book launch like that would make a lot of difference.
It's interesting, like you bring up the mushroom story. Like I still remember cow embryos from Jeff's marketing in the early days. And, you know, just the randomness of some of the niches that product launch formula has been in, and just the success that some people have had by using. And I sometimes don't even like to call it marketing. You know, product launch formula done well is almost like it's not marketing. It's kind of marketing at the highest level because it's not that slimy marketing.
No, it's not buy my stuff. And really the definition of marketing is demand generation. You're increasing the demand for the goods or services or products that you're doing. Sales is the conversion of the demand. So marketing done right is increasing the demand. And that's exactly what product launch formula does. Yeah. And it's done without the intent of buy my stuff, right? Yeah, it's done on the surface, right?
Well, it's like it's not hidden that you're going to sell stuff. A lot of times when there's marketing, it's like there's this hidden and there's this quick bait and switch later on where you like all of a sudden now you've got to buy something. Whereas with product launch formula, it's all out in front. There's no pressure. It relieves all the sales pressure, really. You know, it relieves, like you're still building that tension to a point, but there's no sliminess about it. And it's a beautiful thing done well. It's a beautiful thing.
Well, it's, you know, my definition of the sales process is a guided conversation. And essentially my role as a salesperson, whether it's in a sales letter or whether it's in, you know, a face-to-face or however it is, my role as a salesperson is to clarify your intent. Number one, is this right for you? You know, number two, what are the clarifying questions to answer any uncertainties that you may have for yourself? And it's not me trying to convince you. This is where the sliminess comes in. If you feel like I'm trying to convince you, that's the sliminess. But when I'm guiding you to your own outcome with questions like help me understand and tell me more, or, you know, something similar to that, it's not about buy my stuff. It's about, is this a good fit? And actually, if you take it away from somebody at that point and say, you know, I don't think this is going to be the right thing for you, at least not for another 6 months, you got more that you got to do. the power of becoming a reluctant salesperson is unbelievably powerful. I almost feel like that's a secret weapon that you shouldn't be using.
Yeah. Yeah. I want to switch gears a little bit because you never actually told us your wife's full reaction to the
oh my gosh.
Ding, ding, ding.
Her face, her jaw just dropped and she almost spilled her coffee. And then she sat down and started writing down the 597s every time it dinged.
I can still remember sitting there. It was 2 a.m. and I just remember laughing and just feeling so, so grateful, you know, so grateful and appreciative of such a, you know, you could say it's a complex system like product launch formula, but it is a very simple system once you understand it. And, you know, just having that experience was quite funny looking back on it now. Like nowadays it's kind of expected. It's kind of like, oh yeah, we have to produce a big result and there has to be this and there has to be that. Back then, as I said, I was very naive and it was more pure joy, you know, like just excitement and joy. And it's a beautiful thing. And I actually love, like, from that experience going forward with clients, I love producing that in my clients because I kind of know what's going to happen. Done well, I know roughly, you know, the outcome that's going to happen. And being able to produce that for clients is just a fantastic thing to see their joy and see them go, oh, wow, I didn't, like, you know, I've had many experiences over the years where you produce a huge result and the client's, you know, kind of gobsmacked. it's, yeah, we've got I think we were lucky to have, you know, bumped into each other at the time we did, and bumped into people like Alan. And there's still many people like that around the world that I keep in touch with occasionally, and that have gone on to do huge things with Product Launch Formula, be it with clients or with their own business as well. It's been fantastic.
I think one of the things too, since we're talking about Alan and both of us meeting in Durango, the power of masterminds, and, you know, that's a completely different subject that we can talk about later on down the road, but that's where we met, was in the Product Launch Manager's Mastermind.
Yeah.
And we had a lot of quality time together, unstructured time, sitting out on the veranda by the river, watching the river go by, drinking beer and drinking wine and whatever. It was just great times,
I've got a couple of old photos too. I'll have to send them across to you of that times, and, you know, of all of us together with Alan, with, you know, a lot of the people that were in the group back then.
Originally, and yeah.
Yeah, it's funny how quickly time passes. You know, it has been kind of almost 12 years now. You really do have to remember time is short. You don't know when your number's up. You know, even just, you know, here on the coast, we had a young guy, 21, drown last weekend. Here on the beach, just in front of us. And at 21, he went in for a swim with a couple of mates and didn't come out. And you just really don't know. So, you know, in the marketing space, it's like, go out there and do good things, like use marketing for good, not for evil. And don't just chase the dollar, chase something bigger, like chase a bigger problem, you know, take on a problem worthy of your life and tackle that. Don't just chase the small and the quick payday and the little bit of fame that might come from launching a book or being on stage, or, you know, like, tackle problems that are worthy of yourself.
Purpose driven.
And I think Alan was a great example of that. He, you know, huge-hearted man, hugely genuine guy. And, you know, he was really out there just doing great things with an open heart. You know, like, I as I said, I you don't meet many people like him. So I think this has probably been, I'm not sure about a worthy tribute, but a fitting tribute to someone that was out there doing good things in the world. Any final words, Mark, to wrap up?
I would just say, you know, Alan, you can rest in peace knowing that you made a difference to so many people. A life well lived. Too short, but well lived.
100%. I can't have nothing to add to that. That was fitting, mate. But we will talk again next week. As I said, I hope Alan's up there enjoying it and smiling down upon us. We're certainly thinking of him. And we will talk to you all again next week.
Cheers, everybody.